common sense, kung expiring yung i-deliver, paano magagamit ng tao as a reason to do corruption na yung pinadeliver ay near expiry? Pero pinayagan na palitan yung expiry date. Pinapayagang i-deliver yung next expiry tapos papalitan na lang?
Yes.
Bakit? Napakamahal sa Pilipinas.
Hindi po maliit na pera. 2 billion pesos. So, nasaan po ito?
47 billion funds. You confirmed that the former president actually told you to transfer these funds to the PSDBM.
Just for clarity, no, to the commission and audit, ang mga findings na sinasabi ay nagpa-deliver ang PSDBM ng near-expiry test kits. Tatama ba? Yung mag-expire na test kits?
Madam Chair, that is related to the finding of the special audit team with regard to the shelf life requirement.
Okay. And emergency procurement siya, pero ang nangyari, naging postponed ang delivery. So it defeated the purpose of an emergency procurement. That is what we gathered from your earlier statements. Do we get it right?
Madam Chair, there was a finding on postponements and requests for extension with respect to deliveries.
Okay. Would you have the total quantity of test kits procured? I believe this was a question forwarded to the Department of Health before by Constella. So, the total quantity of test kits procured by the Department of Health. And maybe the DOH, can you help COA dissect? Kasi ang nandiyan dyan ay sets. So sometimes one set is actually 24 test kits or one set is like 10 test kits, depending on the brand. So that we can decipher whether the total number of test kits, not sets, procured were commensurate to the population of the Philippines. Or baka naman masyado na siyang sobra. If the DOH can provide us with that computation. And my next question, sorry if I will be allowed to interject, nagulat kasi kami doon sa findings ng COA, and I believe this should be acted upon. Because DOH never allows delivery of near-expiring commodities. Kasi papapuntang mga barangay yan. Pangalawa kaya nga may emergency procurement kasi kailangan na kailangan na kailangan. Kung sobrang matagal yung delivery, it's actually leading to a second problem. Kapag near expiry ang isang bagay, and I believe Secretary Duque can confirm this, did we have, in your tenure, Secretary Duque, before, in your first tenure as Secretary of Health, was there any instance that we allowed delivery of near expiring commodities in the Department of Health?
We have a policy. We allow until, let me just double check the allowable shelf life, and I'll get back to you in a moment.
Yeah. It's usually 6 to 8 months.
6 to 8 months, you're right, Madam Chair.
But 6 to 8 months is not near expiry. It's not expiry.
Yes, Your Honor.
So was there, to reiterate my question, nagkaroon ba ng pagkakataon sa Departamento ng Kalusugan that you allowed during your first term, your first tenure as Secretary of Health, did you ever allow delivery of near expiry commodities?
If this is with regard to my first term, you are referring to my first term as secretary, the policy is clear that we do not allow the delivery of near-expiry supplies. However, if the expiry is fast approaching, there is an attempt to ask the supplier for a replacement of supplies with a longer shelf life. That is
what you're saying, Secretary Duque, is that pinapayagang i-deliver yung next expiry tapos papalitan na lang?
Yes, Your Honor. May mga ganun po. If my recollection...
Can the DOH confirm this? Because my understanding is we never allow delivery of near-expiring supplies. However, if we have supplies that has been delivered for several months and there is a sudden event that facilitates, like the birth, the pills and the family planning implants, a Supreme Court anti-order decision was issued, then that paved way for the health workers to be prevented from using the Implanon. And so the company was requested to exchange or to return the cash for those that will be expiring because the program was not implemented because of a Supreme Court order. Yun ang pagkaintindi ko. But I can't remember a history in the Department of Health, even when I was still a practicing physician way back in the provinces, maski nung ako estudyante pa, never na nag-a-allow ang gobyerno na mag-deliver ng near-expiring. Because that's common sense. Kung expiring ang i-deliver, paano magagamit ng tao? And if, correct me if I'm right, ang pinapalitan ay yung nag-expire para hindi disadvantages. So do you confirm that, Secretary Duque?
At yung maalala ko po, Madam Chair, it behooves upon the DOH to negotiate with the supplier. Kung halimbawa
So let me reiterate the question. Pag bumibili ba ang DOH ng public health commodity, let's say test kits, pinapayagan nyo ba ang delivery na near expiry?
Under certain circumstances, I have to be...
Can you specify candid? The circumstance that you or the Department of Health allowed the delivery of a near-expiry commodity?
If I recall, I think there were some test kits, Madam Chair, na kasi bago yung kanilang expiry, 6 months. But because nag-evolve yung pandemic, yung mga test kits, ganun din. Hindi nila masabi na itong test kits na to kaya 1 year or kaya 1.5 years. Kasi nga, bago. Wala pang studies, wala pang historical data to show that test kit can actually be extended yung kanyang shelf life. So under very extraordinary circumstances. But if we talk about mga regular supplies, talagang we're strict. I think 2 years or 3 years na dapat bago mag-expire before we do the necessary steps, no? To
So Secretary Duque, parang you are confirming, kasi we were hearing that during the pandemic, myself as one of the volunteers helping as a health worker, you are confirming na yung pinadeliver ay near expiry. Pero pinayagan na palitan yung expiry date.
Hindi po. Hindi pwedeng palitan yung expiry date because that will be tampering.
But you allowed the extension of the expiry date. That was why it was still allowed to be used. So maybe you can dig into the records, the Department of Health, with the help of BSDBM. Nung dumating yung mga test kits, ang expiry niya is, let's say, in 2 months' time. And then, nung nandiyan na, in-extend ng another 6 months. Can you recall that? Because the records will show that. And I believe this is one aspect that the fraud audit team can look into. Because you're correct, delivery of near-expiring test kits were allowed. Pero hindi yata na-mention, kasi alam namin yun sa baba, dahil ginagamit namin when we were swabbing patients. Ang sabi, hindi, okay lang yan na ma-extend. So I believe, yes, that can be done in certain situations. However, for the government buying these test kits at a very premium and expensive price, then yun yung magkaiba. And furthermore, to our representatives under the Commission on Audit, so there are two situations, near expiry, pa-expire na, and then masyadong naging postponed yung delivery, hindi pa parang sa supermarket nakikita natin yung mga commodities, dinidisplay nila naka-sale. Kasi near expiry na, in 1 month or 2 months mag-expire yun. Ginagawa nilang buy one, take one. In this case, binayaran ng gobyerno galing sa perang inutang, umutang, ginamit na pambili, mahal na mahal ang presyo, pero actually near expiring na, at yung delivery, pinostpone siya masyado. Supposed to be, that will pave way for a very much reduced cost of test kit. So, Secretary Duque, why was the unit cost not adjusted?
As I have said earlier, the test kits is part of the overall evolving situation, given that the pandemic, the virus, is a novel virus, and that the test kits had to undergo review of its technical properties and see if these test kits can indeed be extended. I think FDA has a protocol on this, or RITM, but I cannot recall. But in general, the policy is we don't accept near expiry supplies, but again, under ordinary, extraordinary circumstances. Nag-evolve kasi, bago po yung
test. So, Sec, test. Bakit hindi kayo nagreklamo na yung dineliver ay near expiry?
I will have to check, baka meron naman kaming notice, a warning that these are already near expiring. But again, given the extraordinary circumstances, yung pandemic, kailangan natin talaga yung
okay.
mga testing.
Last question, so I'm going to yield to the other members, no? Pasensya lang, I interjected because yan na yung napag-usapang topic. Sec, you keep on repeating na kasi novel yung virus, et cetera, is still being understudied, marami mga announced, that's true. But the price that you have is very, very, very much expensive compared to other countries. With the same brand, the same specs, the same technical everything, bakit napakamahal sa Pilipinas? You don't use the pandemic as a reason to do corruption. And you don't use the pandemic as a reason to abuse the government, borrow money, and let the Filipino people pay. So may we request the Commission on Audit to look into the individual unit cost of the items procured. The silip ba ito sa audit in there?
On finding number one, Your Honor, Madam Chair, we have noted an observation on the price scanning conducted by the PSTBM.
Madam Chair, is it not that the procurement was done by the PSTBM?
Yes, but supposedly.
And Attorney Santiago, and it says here it is based on their parameters. Based on their parameters. So therefore, the PSDBM should also be liable on this because you procured the equipment based on what you think is right, not based on what the DOH need. Diba?
Sir, I will check the record, but there was an agency procurement request po listing the items.
You better because you're sitting down. You're the one sitting it down. Andiyan ka na, no? Yes, you better sir. Because look, ha? Eh, madadamay ka dito.
Oh. I will check po, Mr. Chair, Madam Chair, yung pong kung may attachments po on the technical
yes.
specificities.
Madam Chair, have we invited those that have been mentioned a moment ago that we have given Shoko's order, have we invited them in the previous hearings? And they did not give us any answer at all?
Madam Chair.
Madam Chair.
Yes. Madam Chair, there was an invitation actually sent to PSDBM po, but then we replied po that the persons invited...
No. I'm asking the ComSec if we have invited them in the previous hearing.
Attorney
only Attorney Lloyd Christopher Lau was invited in the previous hearings. But for these hearings, aside from Attorney Lloyd Lau, Ms. Amy De La Cruz, Attorney Jason Mer Uwayan, Attorney Irvin J. Alparaque, Ms. Jerilyn Vergara, Mr. Dixon Panti, and the members of the BAC and Marketing and Sales Division were invited.
So we only have invited Attorney Warren in the previous hearings, Madam Chair.
And Attorney Lloyd Christopher Lau.
Okay. I'd like to warn them that if they're insulting this committee, that after the Shoko's order, that we are going to put him in contempt of this hearing.
That's duly noted. A Shoko's order will already be issued.
May I interject? As it germane to the question of the chairperson, I'd like to ask po, because the delivery actually ensures yung quality and safety of the items. Remember po, nung time na gusto natin pabakunahin yung mga tao, in-encourage natin sila na magbakuna kasi takot. Personally, I would say I was really afraid at that time to take the jab. Kasi we're not really sure kasi experimental pa. May I ask po, was there any, with respect po, no, former secretary, was there any instance where the vaccines, these items were rejected because it was already expired? They were already expired. Was there any instance?
My recollection is when there are impurities in the vaccine vials, yun,
yeah, but in terms of the expiration po, kasi the chairperson, si Congresswoman Garin, was asking you, why do we accept the near-expired na items that should be given and distributed to the people?
Not for the vaccines, Your Honor.
Not for the vaccines.
Not for the vaccines.
But for the vaccines, we're entirely sure that these are all safe.
Yes, pumasok po yan ng proseso. This was vetted by our Health Technology Assessment Council. Okay. And the WHO also vets these vaccines. And before HTAC makes the recommendation to the DOH to purchase it.
Okay.
So, may mga
but
parameters.
The other items that Congresswoman Ganin was asking you kanina po, what are these items? Can you specify kung yung mga ano? Can you at least give us an idea? Kasi yung mga so you're telling us that the vaccines are all the vaccines that we have procured and delivered to you on time, no? On time. Ang assumption natin dito is they were delivered to you on time. We're all safe and not near to its expiration. Ganun po ba?
Yes.
Okay.
That is
and
right.
What are the if I may be allowed, Madam Chair, just follow up lang question. I think what are the other medical items that we have accepted despite the fact that they are near its expiration? Remember po, i-distribute po natin sa mga hospitals yan across the country, no? It requires also yung transportation and etc. And may mga lockdowns, may mga ano. So, ano po yung mga items na ano? Can we ask you to provide us the data, ha? Para
yes,
alam po namin so we would understand fully.
We will do that, Your Honor. I just wanted to reiterate that the test kits, to begin with, really have very short shelf life of 6 months. This particular test kits.
Oh, the test kits.
Yes,
okay.
Kasi may iksi lang talaga. Lalbago.
Yes.
So, kailangan aralin pa yan ulit kung meron na saysay ba na ito i-extend or kung pwedeng i-replace. So, I believe DOH had exercised those options to safeguard the interest
so,
of government.
So, ano po, Secretary? Would you incur charges on the part of the supplier pag sila po yung... Kasi diba, this is what I understand, no? If the supplier delivers a certain item that is not, ano, that does not reach the quality that we are expecting, supposedly dapat incur dyan charges or may gagawin ang, let's say in this case, ang formally, no? To at least compensate, to use a layman's term, no? Sila may kasalanan.
If the technical aspects are not complied with, hindi po pwede. they are rejected.
Mayroon pa silang ano, kasi gusto kong tanungin ang sa findings po ng COA, Madam Chair, if I may be allowed or
just to align, the issue on safety and efficacy is not a problem kasi lahat naman yan dumadaan ng WHO. What was being discussed, including during the previous hearings, was the quantity and the price. Tama si Sec Duque, because it's a new virus, tinitingnan mo. Kaya nga ang tanong, bakit bumili ng napakamilyong-milyong mga test kits with a short shelf life? And now, maybe Sec Duque, can you give us a definition of near expiry? How many days will that be? Or can the DOH inform us what's the definition of near expiry? COA, when you said it's near expiry, anong, from the date of delivery, ilang buwan na lang or ilang weeks na lang siya?
Madam Chair, before COA answers po, no, kasi this is based on your findings, I'm having problem understanding, no? Kasi pag halimbawa, let's assume na kailangan talaga near expiry yung mga items na kailangan talaga. And may mga instances where, sabi po kanina ni Secretary Duque, may mga cases wherein na compromise, I don't think ano compromise or by sira yung mga items na yon. Unang tanong ko is, anong ginagawa para at least yung sa the word itself that I use is para common na ma-understand natin, ano yung ginagawa, what are the incurred na responsibility obligation for the supplier to at least compensate? And I'm having trouble because despite the fact that nagkakaroon ng ganung klaseng problema, multiple pa yung mga transactions na ginawa sa pharmacy.
Wala just kumbaga, to, if I may, no, para medyo mapabilisan lang natin. My understanding, having been with the department for 1.5 years as secretary, when I was briefed, there's such a thing they call delivery schedule. So kapag nagpapabid ka ng volume to take advantage of the volume cost. So para bumaba ang presyo, volume mong bibilhin. Let's say example, you buy 10 million test kits. Included sa procurement is the delivery schedule. So the delivery schedule will say, okay, you deliver the 10 million test kits over a span of 1 year. How many units per quarter or how many units per month? In other words, pag tinanggap mo yan, ang matatanggap mo, let's say, 6 months to expire. Secretary Duque was saying short yung lifespan kasi bago siya. If it's 6 to 8 months, then of course, pwede mo kasi siyang tanggapin, ang expiry niya is at least 5 months. Pero hindi mo tatanggapin yung 100 million test kits. Ang tatanggapin mo, kaya nga may delivery schedule. What I'm getting from COA is that the delivery schedule was not followed. So dalawa yan. Possibly, wala talagang capability ang supplier na binigyan mo. Nag-bid sila, nanalo, at ngayon naghahanap ng supplier. Because the issue here is Secretary Duque kept on saying, and we heard that during the former president's press cons in the evening, sinasabi nilang government-to-government transaction. When you do government-to-government transaction, and that happens, you buy direct from the manufacturer. In this case, the opportunity was there to buy direct from the manufacturer. Bakit dumaan pa sa mga middlemen, mga traders, at naging sobrang mahal? So let me go back. The DOH procures. Pag binili yan, kasama sa bidding, delivery schedule. That's usually spread over 1 year. Susundin mo yun.
Madam Chair.
And last lang.
I'm sorry to interject because I only have 5 minutes here because I have another hearing in the Committee of Human Rights. I just would like to ask Secretary Duque, no? You said that the former president told you about the transfer of funds. So, 47.6 billion. Which the former president actually denied, no, in the paper reports. So are you escaping responsibility for that, Secretary Duque?
Your Honor, Madam Chairperson, in the same press conference that the president had on June 5, he actually said that, or conceded, that he actually gave the go signal for the
Therefore,
fund
you confirm,
transfer.
You confirm that this is what the president said, to transfer the funds.
He gave
the 46,
a go signal.
Yes, 47 sir. Billion funds. You confirmed that the former president actually told you to transfer these funds to the PSDBM.
Well, there was no amount because the amount had to be determined by processes within the DOH. And I, as the Secretary of Health, had effected the transfer of funds representing payments of the PPEs and COVID-19 pandemic supplies.
Sana lang, Madam Chair, and I'm PSDB. Going to end this question. No, the findings of COA, nakalagay dito, the transfer of aggregate amount of 47.6 billion without a MOA, setting the terms of reference between the parties. This MOA should have included item specifications, delivery schedules, and remedies in case of default. As a result, PSDBM procured items based on its parameters, leading to lapses and irregularities in the procurement contract. Do you believe this, Secretary Duque? Do you accept this?
I don't accept that. In fact, Madam Chair and the honorable members, this is now a subject of a pending case with the ombudsman. So I would like to reiterate that we will await the ombudsman's decision on this. All these allegations have already been embodied in the ombudsman case, and to which we filed our motion for reconsideration. But so far, no or decision has come out of our MR. Thank you, Madam Chair.